Deep state enters next phase of coup, ex-CIA agent confirms government will kill him, civil war is here. As the political establishment's attempts to remove the president from office based on criminal investigations are unraveling, the possibility of a bloodless coup fades, but they're not going to give up. If left no other option, our own government will redden its hands. Alex Jones on InfoWars warned the criminal indictment against Michael Flynn and other members of Trump's campaign are parts of the globalists' plot to overthrow the president, but they are not going to give up if they can't get rid of the president with legal action. They're growing desperate, and it's increasingly likely they will resort to their final solution. If they can't impeach him, they will try to kill him. I don't think they're going to be able to remove Trump with all of this made-up Russia stuff, but they're clearly going to go to their next plan to kill him, and they've been warming that up. And I don't even like the different scenarios that are there of what we are going to have to do to counter-strike against this. Think that's crazy? There is terrifying evidence already out there that confirms another JFK-style assassination plot against Trump is be underway. In August, CNN counterterrorism analyst and former deputy FBI director Phil Mudd, who worked for the CIA and FBI when Robert Mueller was the director, came directly out on a live interview with Jake Tapper and said that the government is going to kill Trump because he doesn't support them. From Real Clear Politics. Let me give you one bottom line as a former government official, Mudd began. The government is going to kill this guy. Trump, defense Vladimir Putin, their State Department, and CIA officers are coming home. And at Langley and in Foggy Bottom, State Department headquarters, CIA and state they're saying, this is how you defend us? We saw the same thing in his transgender comments. What is the military saying to him on transgender? Show us the policy. You know what that means inside government, ain't going to happen. What did the Department of Justice say on Paul Manafort? You can say what you want, a judge told us we caused to search his home early in the morning because we don't trust the guy who was your campaign manager, he said. The government is going to kill this guy because he doesn't support them, Mudd declared. Tapper pressed him further, asking him if he wasn't just speaking metaphorically. But it was confirmed that he was speaking literally of an inside attempt at Trump's life later in the interview. What I'm saying is government, people talk about the deep state, when you disrespect government officials who've done 30 years, they're going to say, really? You send Vladimir Putin sends U.S. officers home and you support him before us? Earlier this year, former presidential candidate Ron Paul also warned that Trump's political situation bears frightening similarities to the situation John F. Kennedy found himself in before the CIA assassinated him. Which president had the following accusations cast against him? 1. He has betrayed the Constitution, which he swore to uphold. 2. He has committed treason by befriending Russia and other enemies of America. 3. He has subjugated America's interests to Moscow. 4. He has been caught in fantastic lies to the American people, including personal ones, like his previous marriage and divorce. President Trump? No, it was President Kennedy. Mike Cernovich, independent conservative reporter, has also warned about the coming plot to assassinate Trump. If they ban us from YouTube, that's when Trump will be killed, there's no question about it. Cernovich said. They're going to kill us, they're going to kill him, they're going to kill everybody. While the deep state plot to blow Trump's brains out from miles away or bomb his motorcade could still be in the works, the left-wing genocide on Trump supporters is already being waged. According to former U.S. Army Reserve Lieutenant Colonel Anthony Schaffer, Las Vegas shooter Stephen Paddock's profile and actions bear striking parallels to the motivations of James Hodgkinson, who attempted to snipe and kill Republican officials at a congressional baseball game this summer in Alexandria. Schaffer confirmed it's beyond dispute that Paddock, who allegedly shot to death 58 people at a country music festival from his perch at the Mandalay Bay Hotel, was deliberately targeting white conservative Trump supporters. From InfoWars. This was a legitimate target of political expression, said Schaffer, adding that the left has now encouraged the use of violence as an extension and use of political speech. It isn't just because Trump rubs his thumb into the politically correct culture of the rhino, Democratic establishment. Trump is the first president in a long time who is actively opposed and working against the military-industrial complex that has held the true power in the United States and the world for many decades.